Hey everyone, welcome to the channel. It's Rad from Radko Tarot, and in this whole video we're going to look into Leo Sun, Leo Moon, and also Leo Rising weekly general tarot reading August 9th up until August 15th 2021. And in this video I'm going to use the technique called Elemental Dignities, which will allow me to read tarot in pairs, literally, and you can do it even in triples, as I am showing. Just hold on a second. As I am showing into my, oh my God, into my daily videos at my Facebook page. And if you are interested into this technique, I have developed a course for it, a 1 hour lecture accompanied with also a PDF handbook. And right now is on a sale for a $40. As well, if you are interested into my full tarot course, or you do wish to have a personal reading with me, you can go to my website, which is listed here into the post, or into the, not comments, but description down below. And there you can view both of these services, and as well purchase if you do wish. And finally, if you do want to catch me live here on YouTube, make sure you do subscribe to the channel and hit the notification bell. So with that being set aside, moving to the Leo reading of the week, the first card you do have, Leo, that is to be the Ace of Cups, followed by the second card here, which stands as the Ten of Swords. That is very interesting. That could go two ways, okay? Two ways. And we are going to see that through the Elemental Dignities, how it's going to go. Followed by the Page of Cups, okay? And finally, what we have for you, that is going to be the Ten of Cups. So it's going to go the good way, right? It's going to go the good way, or it's going to finish the good way. How this interaction in between the Ace of Cups and the Ten of Swords is going to play out, we're going to see from the catalysts that are going to show up. We are going to have four more cards, which are to be catalysts to the first four. But all in all, this week, for what it seems, it will be a week of a turnaround. And that turnaround should happen into the rather early stages of the week. And for some of you, Leo, that turnaround may not be something you are going to face pleasantly, although a person is going to show up into your environment, which is going to be able to revitalize, so to speak, your positive outlook toward the future. And from there, things are just taking off. Now, this individual could play even bigger role out there. For now, this is as much as I can say. We're going to see the catalyst, and then I will be able to tell you much more, because it's very possible, plausible, this person to be emotionally related to you. In other words, to have either hidden feelings or straight away open feelings towards you, and so on and so forth. So starting up with the Ace of Cups here, which is catalyzed by the Princess of Wands, or that is a Page of Wands, we do have a passive enemies, okay? Passive enemies, and it is, it's a very difficult elemental dignity to describe and to explain. So what we have in these two cards, it is the... Well, there will be some new circumstances that are to surround your situations, career-wise or relationship-wise. New circumstances which are okay, which are good, all right? It is just the timing for them is going to be rather inappropriate. They should have happened either earlier, or they should have waited a little bit later. Most likely those circumstances are going to come by through some kind of a news, which under normal circumstances would have been very positive news, but right now you wouldn't be very happy of hearing that news, career-wise or relationship-wise. And that is going to disrupt your pleasant environment, because other than this news or these new circumstances, so to speak, your life is going to go in a rather good direction. Here, the Ace of Cups, it is a signifier, so to speak, for an impending change toward the better, where thine reality is transcended into something much, much brighter, and issues are resolved, and so on and so forth. Ace of Cups, it's the pure love, but that is the love for life itself. It doesn't have to be a romantic one, all right? However, it could be. But this news, but just the sheer fact that it is something new that you have not accounted for by that point, it will be a problem. And you are going to opt to solve that problem the radical way, the way we see here with the Ten of Swords. And it is accompanied by the Four of Cups. We do have a active neutrals. And because they are neutrals, the Ten of Swords is not going to hit you that hard, or at least the negative side of the Ten of Swords is not going to hit you that hard. Here, this is how these cards stand. So what happens, it is when that news, that new thing comes about, which is quite unaccounted for, or you haven't accounted for it, you're going to make a retrospective, like a drawing a line, scoping up what is going to accomplish for you, how is going to reflect your good development by now, and so on and so forth. What are the pros and the cons? And if we didn't have the Four of Cups here, then the pros and the cons are going to be very black and white. However, now with the Four of Cups into this, into the equation, it does speak that you are going to also take under the account the accomplishments thus far, the fruits of your labor thus far. And therefore, the decision that you're going to make about the new direction, either you're going to take it or you won't. And in this particular case, you're going to find a way how to take it partially even, you know, or at least sustain it until you do have the capabilities to take it. It will be not that drastic, because usually with the Ten of Swords, we do have that irrevocable decision or irreversible action that Tao does, and there is no going back from it. But that is not going to be the case that this time. So these mid stages of the week, you can expect to be way more understanding toward the environment and make decisions in such a way that after that, you can go back to, or in other words, you are going to leave a back door to making a correction or exam. I don't know how to say it, you know, to fix things if something goes wrong. And right after that, this person comes about or steps in into your environment. That could be a person you already know, or it could be just somebody brand new. And it is accompanied with the Seven of Wands. We do have a passive enemies, and that is a person who despises. It's just, it is sick to their stomach if there is something hidden. That is a person who straight away hates drama. They do hate gossips, they do hate rumors, they do hate surreptitious intentions. Although it is a person who is very scattered and they don't have anything theirs. They don't, how can I say, they just are not good into sustaining things. And are they going to have an emotional attachment to you? Most likely. But that emotional attachment is fading away. They almost gave up on it with that Seven of Wands. They think that they cannot hold you for them, either career-wise or either relationship-wise. They cannot hold you as a career partner, for example. They cannot hold your friendship, or they cannot hold your love. They don't have what it takes to sustain, for example, your love. And if that's the case, you need to make sure that, how can I say, that you are faithful for them, if you do want to be faithful for them or to them. With the page of, with the appearance of the Page of Cups, a change is going to start looming on the horizon either way. And if not anything else, this individual, this person will help you reassess your positions, career-wise or relationship-wise, and foresee either partial or entire a new future for yourself, either a partial overview or a entire overview in front of you, and will allow you to to position yourself in such a way to be able to make the most out of that overview. And finally, you are ending up the week here with the 10 of cups, and it is, oh my god, accompanied with the world card. So you're going to be happy at the end of the week, very satisfied of your accomplishments and your achievements throughout the week, having no regret whatsoever, whatever decision or action you make, you made, especially back into this elemental dignity that we had, 10 of swords with the 4 of cups. Additionally to it, if you have lost faith, if you have lost the worth for life, that faith and that worth is going to either slowly, progressively, or all of a sudden going to be regained back. With the world card catalyzing the 10 of cups, which they do form a passive friends, a very strong catalyst, and it speaks that this happiness is going to be there to stay. It's going to be yours because it will be a culmination of things that nobody can take away from you. So if you develop love throughout the week, or you do have love throughout the week, it is yours to take, it is yours to enjoy. Nobody can take away that from you. Same thing about jobs, same thing about friendships, you know, about business, family. And it is like at the end of the week, you are going to feel like you are in this protective bubble, that oasis that nothing can actually touch you in it. So with that being said, Leo, that was your weekly general tarot reading, guys, August 9th up until August 15th, 2021. Hopefully you do enjoy it and you do liked it, and we are to see each other next time. Until then, bye.